there, all ethnicities, all ages, never even picked up cameras before, and we're coming together to create a documentary.
It's so important to really raise awareness and give support to women that are suffering.
Mary Kay is doing a great job by creating these documentaries, and being a part of Mary Kay Inspiring Stories is inspiring to me.
The thing that is most amazing about these women is what they have overcome.
I came from Guatemala when I was like 10, 11, and I was here with my parents. And then until now, you know, I got married and have two kids.
My name is Jessalyn. I am originally from Houston, Texas. I am a writer, director. Now I'm here in Los Angeles. Been here for about 3 years pursuing my dream of becoming a feature film director and a TV writer.
My name is Robin Lamore. I am currently working as an art therapist. I have two boys that are 15 and 13. I did not for a million years think that I would ever become the victim of domestic violence.
How can someone find joy when they're faced with such hard situations?
And I thought I knew everything there was to know about men and life, and I look back now and the red flags were gigantic. We met in Aspen. He was the stable attorney in Orange County, and I was the artistic wife.
He got jealous when I was away and wanted me with him all the time, and anything I said or did like really affected him.
One thing led to another, and you know, he started cheating on me, and it's just like escalate to other stuff.
His mother was living with us, and I wasn't working, and I thought she was rehabilitating from a hip surgery. I didn't realize that he drank during lunch. So when he came home one night, I mentioned something about how many more weeks his mother was going to be staying with us. And he hit me hard. And it wasn't a joke. It was, don't talk to me about my mother, ever.
I was about to go back to Austin to finish up some work for school and do an internship. And he wanted to come with me, but I didn't think it was appropriate at that time. We'd only been dating for a few months. And he just shook me. And he talked to me about how much I didn't understand what I was doing to him. And if I loved him, I wouldn't treat him like that. And I felt really bad. I felt like if I loved him more, if I made him feel more secure, he wouldn't be doing that.
I ended up seeing a psychiatrist who, ironically, wanted to see me stay married. And had me working on coping skills of living with this man, opposed to really listening to my story and the problems that I was having.
It's really lonely being a battered wife. You know, we isolate ourselves and other people don't know what to do with us. And I think there's this feeling that she's unstable. I don't want to get involved because she's unstable.
I tried to leave a couple times, but it just had like a cane in the back, you know, trying to.
He beat me on February 12th, 2003, before Valentine's. Nobody else believed my story, but the doctor saw the bruises and all the abrasions. I had just been released from the hospital at, let's say, 5-6 o'clock in the morning, and I wanted to go home, and the doctor said, no, stay at my house. And I said, I need to go home because of the kids. So I went home, and he was away, and he just forcibly threw me up against the wall, and that was it. That was kind of the defining moment where if you could be that abusive, that quickly, again, I knew I was in trouble.
He got on my face and he grabbed me from my neck, picked me up. So I came and I grabbed him and I scratched him so he would let me go. He punched me while I had my son.
We had this huge epic, like on the freeway, in the streets fight. He came after me and he was walking up with my stepson's hand, holding his hand, screaming and yelling at me. And that's when I knew I can't do this anymore. I can't teach that little boy that it's okay to live like this.
A couple days later, around that time, I had the courage to call one of my sisters, and you know, because I just said, enough is enough, and you know, I just have to get out.
Joy. What does that word mean if we really think about it? What does it mean for these women?
Can you remember a time when you were happy? Can you remember a time that you did something fun before you knew this person? If you can get your brain back to something that was joyful then, you can probably wrap yourself around something that will make you relive that joy getting through the worst part of the domestic violence.
I felt that I had hope and that someday that I was going to have joy and, you know. To discover joy would be how I make choices and live my life now. Just being able to be here and, you know, be alive.
There's a lot of joy in my life right now. I'm having a bit of movement with my career, and joy for me really is the work I do, my art, writing, and directing.
If you can just get a vision or an idea of what you're working for or going towards or something that you want for yourself, I'll joke, there's a light at the end of the tunnel, we hope it's not a train. But there is joy.
Joy. None of the answers have anything in common, except laughter. They're all laughing. What is it with that word joy?
I now know that joy comes from within. I'm really at that stage in my life. I had to find peace within myself.
I found joy in the fact that I was taking my life back.
You know, my whole life and joy right now is just be so grateful having the family that I have.
I wonder if joy is like a light within us. That seems like a great image for joy. So if joy is like a light, when things get tough, that light must be really small. After a while, you must spend a lot of time just trying to find that light. How do we find it?
Do I believe that joy is something that other people can experience of domestic violence? Absolutely.
Now I live life in between, and I know how to have clear boundaries, and I'm responsible for protecting them. And I make much better choices about the people I invite into my life.
Just having my kids and, you know, call my babies, I do have joy now.
It's amazing to think that no matter the situation, the light, the joy within us will never go out.
It takes time, some perseverance, some amazing girlfriends, one foot in front of the other. Some days you barely drag yourself out of bed. Some days look bleak. Others you're elated because something great happened. But it starts to all fall into place and start to work.
Each one of them continues on their road in their own way, but the joy they found in climbing out of the darkness is incredible. They can now find joy in every day. And once they've found joy within themselves, the world around them could be filled with it too. Joy is possible. Joy is powerful.